Good morning, everybody. It is incredible to be able to stand here right now and look around at a labor of love, shall we say, for 15 years in the making, 5 years of actual construction, and to be able to welcome you to you all today. My name is Thomas Steinhauer, the Regional Vice President for Seasons and the General Manager of this property. I should say I'm lucky to be the guy who's here now. And for me, this is an incredible culmination of hard sweat and emotions. And at the same time, I'm still in awe of what has been created here by our partners. Just a couple of things. I know we've left some fact sheets and so forth for some of you, but 443 beautiful guest rooms, all larger than 500 square feet, with balconies, of course, golf, 5-acre recreation, water park, 5 imaginative variety of dining options, very, very important, obviously, in the resort business, 18 treatment room, luxury spa and salon, 2 ballrooms, 38,000 square feet of meeting space, located within the magnificent Walt Disney World Resort, and Disney's new luxury home enclave Golden Oak, an oasis of tranquility, you want to call it? How can we go wrong? We're set to succeed. Beautifully Spanish, if you look at the whole design of it and where does it all come from, and the thoughts that went into it. I mean, we have the Spanish revival arrival that fits perfectly into this community and gives you a sense of warmth and welcome. At the same time, condor. And then you look inside. So it's Wibbly Tommy Lou in the architectural firm HKS who led the architectural design. It's complemented by a wonderful blend of elegance, whimsy, interior-wise, by Anderson Miller, and the dynamic design of the restaurants by Puccini. So look at the amount of design thoughts that have to go into something like this to make it all work. The first time that I really was set back, once I got off the grandness of the structure itself, was when I looked up and I saw these light fixtures go in. And they're a discovery of their own. Everywhere you go, there is yet another kind of design. And as a typical operator, I was like, oh, how are we going to clean those? And then I was, this is pretty spectacular. So we've pushed into a realm that is maybe not viewed from a typical hotel operator's point of view as practical, but let me tell you from a perspective of being in awe and saying this is something very special that I think has been achieved. So thank you, Cam. 5,000 jobs were created through the construction of this. So think about this for just a moment, what this meant during a time that was quite difficult overall. Just to get through it, at one point there was a peak of almost 1,000 people working here in a single day. But that's what it takes. So it was also a wonderful time for people to go and get work and do things and be part of something special. And over all those years, I think it's really something to be proud of as well. Of course, we started to hire. We've hired so far 500 people, and out of this community, I want to say it's about 70% straight coming to us from all walks of life, actually, because we have so many facets of our operation. So to me, this is yet another base, another foundation from an employment point of view that has been very important. But what I found so refreshing is that we have so many service-oriented people in this environment. I think a lot of it has to do with, at some point they worked for Disney, at some point they worked for another hotel. They have figured it out. In many communities, that is not a given, that you have that kind of a natural, I can slip into the service piece. So this is really, really special for us. Eventually, I think we will be very close to 1,000 people, quite frankly, and I think we'll grow into that in the next year, given the pace of reservations that I see so far. Close to 500 team members share all the special moments, coming in, trying to figure out where is what, how do the systems work, and how do I work through all the bumps. I can tell you it has and they have a whole list of things that obviously they have to achieve, but I know they're set up for success, the foundation is right, and I know this is a very, very special moment. Thank you all for coming and joining us, because it's going to be in our hearts for a long time. So, Disney, Reedy Creek, right here, Golden Oak, is our direct neighborhood, and Orlando, the greater Orlando, is our destination. I think we're going to be, I know we're going to be a very responsible member of this community, and if we have continued to be open with those wonderful, welcome with those wonderful open arms we've experienced today, we're going to be home. So without any further ado, what I would like to do is introduce Chris Hunsberger, who oversees our America's properties and has joined us, came down from Washington, Toronto, etc. A warm welcome to you to this table.
Thanks, Thomas. I have to tell you, I opened a resort on a smaller scale, it was about 20 years ago, for Four Seasons. And when I was opening the resort, I did not look nearly as good as Thomas does standing in front of you here today. I was a bit, I'm bragging at the time. Thomas looks like he's been on a holiday for the last couple of years. And Thomas said, he's blessed to be here. I have to tell you, Thomas is the pick of the litter from the Four Seasons colleagues that he's surrounded with. He has some very talented colleagues around the world. And we are most fortunate, those of you that are here and call Orlando home, are most fortunate to have Thomas Steinhauer as the general manager and regional vice president of this hotel. We're so fortunate to have you here, Thomas. Back to the script. I have to tell you, as Thomas said, this resort is 15 years in the making. There's not too many properties that have to take that long to get from sort of initial idea to actually getting the doors open. But it's great to be standing here in front of you today enjoying this very important milestone of the ribbon-cutting ceremony where we're welcoming the public, the guests, and others to this hotel, which we consider to be best in class by Four Seasons standards, and we certainly hope you'll feel the same way about it if you have had a chance to tour the property. Of course, as Thomas alluded to, but I'm just going to go on a little bit further, none of this would not be possible if it weren't for a team that was committed and passionate and have given a tremendous amount of time and energy and resources to open the doors of this resort to you today. I'd just like to name a few of them because Four Seasons feels very fortunate to have them as vested stakeholders in allowing us to be where we are today. First and foremost, our owners, our partners in this project, Silverstone Properties and New Real Estate Partners, have been with us since the inception. They stood by us side by side. They believed in this project. They believed in the vision that we had and that Thomas further brought to life with his team. And what you see here as you walk around the property and as you tour it, I think is really best in class by Four Seasons standards. We certainly think is best in class here in this community. And so very fortunate to have Silverstein and Dune as our partners and owners here in this property. Secondly, a project like this doesn't happen without a lot of bodies and capable, skilled craftsmen and others that bring it all to life. As Thomas said, at some point in time, there's been upwards of thousands of people on site here working on the project over the last couple of years. But we've been very fortunate to have a committed set general contractor, subcontractor, there's lots of trades involved to get this property to the level of perfection it's at today. As Thomas will tell you, we're never quite there, but we're going to get there in the days ahead. But we're really fortunate to have the physical hardware that we now have in Fall Four Seasons Resort Orlando. We also are very blessed, as Thomas alluded to, being surrounded by a community that has welcomed us from the very beginning. To be here in the Golden Oaks community, which is certainly one of the most prestigious communities in all of Orlando, and then above and beyond all that, to be a part of the Orlando community. We've wanted to be in Orlando for decades, and it's really great that we're finally here, and we have a Four Seasons and a flag on the ground here. And maybe it took a little longer for us to get here than others, but we're really happy with what we've ended up with and the location that we have. And we really appreciate the very warm reception that we've had from the local community and how you've embraced us and how we're working hard to be a part of this community. Of course, nothing is ever possible in the world of hospitality, as our Disney colleagues would also allude to, if it weren't for the people inside the property that bring it all to life. And we're fortunate, as I said, to have Thomas as the leader, but this property is so unique because of the fact that we really think that we found some of the best in the community who were sort of waiting for us to arrive here in the Orlando community. But we're also very fortunate that we had almost 25% of our staff complement coming from other Four Seasons hotels, not only in North America, but from around the world. We have not seen sort of the draw or the pull like this before. So I think it speaks to the excitement internally also within Four Seasons of opening the doors of what we consider to be clearly one of our best resorts in the Four Seasons portfolio. And we know that that group of employees are going to, as they've already demonstrated in the early days of opening the property, demonstrate their unwavering commitment to service and delivering it in a passionate and dedicated way that really responds to the needs of the many different types of customers that come here to Orlando. This, of course, one of the most unique things about this property is the coming together of what we consider perhaps one of the most iconic brands in the world, and that is our colleagues from Disney, and Four Seasons, which is a company that hasn't been around as long as Disney. We've been at it for about 50 years now, but we're so fortunate to bring these two brands together, and the partnership that has been demonstrated by our Disney colleagues is second to none. And the support they've shown and how they've worked with Thomas and the team and our entire Four Seasons team to support us and allow us to realize this vision. So we're very blessed and very fortunate, very thankful for all that our Disney colleagues have done. This property represents the 39th Four Seasons Hotel in the Americas, and we're very excited about that. And like every property we build, our goal is to try to make sure that the most recent one is truly best in class. Well, I have to tell you, whether it was Thomas's doing with the commitment of our ownership, with the commitment of men, I think Thomas actually took the bar up two or three notches. It's been a long time before someone comes along and opens another property quite at this stature and at this quality level and the completeness of the experience and the physical side of what we have to offer here. It's really second to none, and it's truly a feather in our cap, and we're most fortunate to be opening. Just a couple words in closing. As I mentioned before, the team here is something that we've been very blessed with. I had an opportunity to arrive here last night. I felt like I had arrived at a well-tuned hotel that we've been running for 5 or 6 years now. We know it's only going to get better over the weeks and days ahead. But I can tell you, just walking around the hotel last night and again this morning, the energy, the passion of this team is second to none. And their commitment to really wanting to raise the bar. And that competitive streak in us is strong here in Four Seasons. We know that there's some great competitors here in the marketplace. I can tell you the team is humbly stepping up to the challenge and wanting to really raise the bar throughout the portfolio here. As Thomas mentioned, the physical side of the hotel here is very complete. Whether it's golf or tennis or spa or the water park or the various amenities we have, restaurants that are bound throughout the property. It goes on and on and on. But for us, as a mainland resort, this would certainly be the ideal of what we'd be trying to design. And we're very fortunate that all of that has become a reality. That, coupled ultimately with the iconic magic of Disney, we believe the synergy of those experiences, the talent we have, the physical property, and then the experience that Disney provides on top of that will really allow us open this property to a tremendous demand. As Thomas has said right now, slowly turning on the faucet, deciding how much business to take. But the good news is that we've seen tremendous demand already for this property and really look forward to a very exciting opening of the weeks and days ahead. So in closing, I truly want to thank you all for being here with us today. The Four Seasons feel very blessed to be finally in the Orlando community and part of this tremendous Disney complex. We are most grateful for that. Thank you. It's not too often in your life, Mike, that you have a chance to introduce two really high-profile people. I've introduced some high-profile people before in my lifetime. But I have a distinct pleasure now in introducing the stage Tom Wolber from Disney, but also the first time ever in my life.
good morning and welcome to a very, very special day here at Walt Disney World and a remarkable day for our beautiful community of Golden Oak. This to us is far, far more than the arrival of a magnificent new hotel at the world's premier vacation destination. This is a collaboration and a resonance of two companies that guests really, really love. Four Seasons is known internationally for elegant accommodations, for extraordinary experiences, and a signature style that many discerning travelers seek out when they travel around the world. And Disney is known for unmatched family vacation experiences, for exceptional guest service, and a tradition of personalized excellence. We make incredible moments that become lifetime memories for our guests, and for an atmosphere here that can be described only as magical. As the representative of a company that is known for its storytelling, it pleases me enormously that beginning today, the Four Seasons and the Disney Company will start telling a lot of new stories together. On behalf of the nearly 7,000 cast members in Central Florida, it is my deep pleasure to welcome Four Seasons and its staff to what is truly the place where dreams come true. And now, you want to get some ribbons cut?
Absolutely.
Let's do it. Thank you so much.
We will see you down there. Thank you very much again for coming.